Hello dear student, how are you? Now in this lecture I am going to discuss about equilibrium state, chemical equilibrium related to volume first and class 11th. Chemical equilibrium. It is very effective and numerical based chapter. It is highly effective chapter. And each and every concept of this chapter is directly indirectly related to numerical. So it is my advice to all of you that we concentrate, because this is the chapter belongs to physical chemistry, okay, and very effective chapter. First of all, about rate of reaction. The concentration of reactant which used to convert into product under per unit time. The concentration of reactants which used to convert into product under per unit time is called rate of reaction. Okay, the concentration of reactant which used to convert into product under per unit time is called rate of reaction. Okay, therefore rate is equal to dx over dt. What is the dx? Dx integrate about, disintegrated amount whole upon dt. dt means time taken in disintegration. This is known as rate of reaction. Clear? I hope everybody come to know about the rate of reaction. If the amount of reactant, if the concentration of reactant which is going to convert into product, it has a small quantity, then it is indicated by the dx. And time taken, that will also be small quantity. And that is also denoted by dt. If the disintegrated amount present a large scale, okay, then it is denoted by rate of reaction is equal to delta x upon delta t. We can also represent any rate of any chemical reaction by this expression. If the concentration of reactant which is going to convert into product is present in large scale, then no doubt the value of time taken must be higher. So it is denoted by delta t. I hope everybody come to know what is the difference between dx and delta x. ये आपको अच्छी तरह से जानकारी होनी चाहिए. Now rate law. Now I will discuss about rate law. What is the rate law? According to this law, the rate of any chemical reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant. The the rate of any chemical reaction. Rate of any chemical reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant. Concentration of reactants. Okay? For example, suppose for the given reaction, A gives out B. Suppose this is a simple chemical reaction is given. A gives out B. Therefore, its rate, either we can write dx or dt or simply R, directly proportional to the concentration of reactant. This is the reactant and this one is considered to be the product. Then rate of this reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant. And you know what is this? This one is the symbol of concentration. Okay? This is the symbol of concentration. And what is the concentration? Molarity. Simply you know well. Molarity. Molarity is said to be the concentration. Number of moles absolute present in 1 liter volume of solution is known as molarity. And molarity is known as concentration. And here we can't use the word molarity. We have to use word concentration. And whose symbol is this? Okay, like this. Clear? Suppose for the reaction A plus B gives out C plus D. Suppose this is reaction is given. Then its rate directly proportional to the concentration of A into concentration of B. Clear? Suppose the related reaction. Suppose related reaction is given like this. N1A plus N2B gives out N1C plus N2D. Then its rate of reaction directly proportional to the concentration of A to power N1 into concentration of B to power N2. I hope now everybody come to know what do you mean by the rate of reaction? आपको clear हो गया होगा कि how will you explain to the rate of reaction? आप निकाल सकते हैं. Means the rate of any chemical reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactant. If more than one reactants are present in chemical reaction, then rate of related chemical reaction must be directly proportional to the product of the concentration of reactant. Means this coefficient used to convert into power. Clear? Clear? Now, rate constant. Now we have to define about rate constant. How will you explain basically about the rate constant? Rate constant. Suppose for the given reaction, this reaction is given. A gives out B. Okay? And its initial concentration, A. Then it must be zero. Why? Initial concentration का मतलब हुआ है before starting the reaction. और जब reaction start ही नहीं हुई है, then you know well, its the amount of the formation of product must be zero. because reaction has not started. And one thing, let the degree of dissociation is equal to x. Either you consider it x or you can consider as alpha. Then it is very very important. क्या जो बहुत जरूरी है, इसके जितने मोल होंगे उतने गुना x निकलेगा और इसके जितने मोल होंगे उतने गुना x बनेगा. इसके कितने मोल है वन, तो इससे x निकलेगा. छोटा सा लिख लेते हैं और इसमें x मोल बनेगा. Only for understanding purpose. Therefore, final concentration. Final concentration is concentration after time t. Initial concentration of A is small a. And x moles of A used to convert into B. Therefore, the remaining concentration A minus x. And here, इसका जो initial होता है उसमें जोड़ दिया जाता है. तो initial zero होता तो x रहेगा. इसमें से initial से इसको घटा दिया जाता है. तो यहां a माइनस एक्स हो जाएगा. यदि यहां टू होता तो टू एक्स निकलता, यहां थ्री लिखा होता तो थ्री एक्स बनता. हेयर यू नो a माइनस एक्स, व्हाट इज a माइनस एक्स, a माइनस एक्स इज सेड टू बी चेंज इन कंसंट्रेशन. ओके क्लियर. देयर इट्स आर डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू a माइनस एक्स, विच इज इंप्लाइज r इज इक्वल टू k a minus x. And here you know, here k is the rate constant. Dear students, here k is considered to be the rate constant. K यहां पर rate constant है. But we have not only to find out the rate constant, but we have also defined to this. हमें इसको डिफाइन भी करना है. वी मस्ट डिफाइन टू दिस. और हमें डिफाइन करने के लिए क्या करना होगा, ऐसे हम मैथमेटिकली अपनाए तो k इक्वल टू r अपॉन a माइनस x, कोई सोल्यूशन इसमें नहीं आएगा. देयरफॉर लेट a माइनस x इक्वल टू वन. व्हाट डू मीन बाय दिस, a माइनस x इक्वल टू वन मीन्स यूनिट concentration change means one mole of reactant is going to convert into product. Now applying this value in this equation, since r equal to k a minus x, which is implies r is equal to k, or in place of a minus x that is one ho jayega. A minus x ki jagah one rakh denge, it becomes r equal to k. Then how will you define? It means the rate constant of any chemical reaction, the rate constant of any chemical reaction is equal to that rate of reaction whose unit concentration change take place. किसी chemical reaction का जो rate constant होता है वो reaction की उस rate की उसकी value रिएक्शन टू उस रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन की इक्वल होगी जिसका यूनिट कंसंट्रेशन चेंज टेक प्लेस. दैट्स व्हाई आर इक्वल टू के. हेंस वी कैन डिक्लेयर द रेट कांस्टेंट ऑफ एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन इज, द रेट कांस्टेंट ऑफ एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन इज इक्वल टू दैट रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन हुज यूनिट कंसंट्रेशन चेंज टेक प्लेस. क्लियर, दिस इज गोइंग टू क्लियर नाउ ना. ओके, तो नाउ after explaining about the concentration, rate of reaction, and rate law, as well as rate constant, now I am going to discuss about reversible reaction as well as irreversible reaction. Because equilibrium word is associated with reversible reaction. Reversible reaction, that chemical reaction in which product also convert into reactant, product can also convert into reactant, is known as reversible reaction. As A plus B reversible C plus D, that this is the RL, एंड दिस वन इज द आरबी. आरएम हुज इंडिकेट करता है, दिस यूज टू इंडिकेट अबाउट द रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन. एंड आरबी यूज टू इंडिकेट अबाउट रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन. रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन एज वेल एज रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन. एंड दिस एरो यूज टू इंडिकेट अबाउट द फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन. ओके. एंड दिस एरो यूज टू इंडिकेट फॉर द बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन. फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन एज वेल एज बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन. आरएफ रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन. आरबी यूज टू इंडिकेट अबाउट द रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन. क्लियर. इन दिस रिएक्शन फॉर द फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन ए एंड बी इज रिएक्टिंग एंड सी एंड डी इज द प्रोडक्ट. एंड फॉर द बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन सी एंड डी इज रिएक्टिंग ए एंड बी इज प्रोडक्ट. सच केमिकल रिएक्शन इज टू बी रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन. एंड देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर वर्ड इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. व्हाट अबाउट इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस? यू नो फॉर रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन इनिशियली द रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन इज मैक्सिमम एंड रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन इज अबाउट टू नेग्लिजिबल. बट आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग सम टाइम एज द सॉरी आरबी बट आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग टाइम आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग सम टाइम एज द वैल्यू ऑफ रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन यूज टू इंक्रीज देन द वैल्यू ऑफ रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज. एंड आफ्टर सम टाइम आरएफ बिकम्स इक्वल टू आरबी. दैट स्टेट ऑफ एनी रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन इज नोन एज इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. इट मीन्स वी कैन डिक्लेयर दैट स्टेट ऑफ एनी दैट स्टेट ऑफ एनी रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन एट विच रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन मस्ट बी इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन. दिस स्टेट ऑफ रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन इज नोन एज इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. एट इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट बिकम्स इक्वल टू द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. क्लियर. समझ गए ना? दैट स्टेट ऑफ एनी रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन दैट स्टेट ऑफ एनी रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन एट विच आर या रेट ऑफ फॉरवर्ड रिएक्शन बिकम्स इक्वल टू रेट ऑफ बैकवर्ड रिएक्शन देन दिस स्टेट इज कॉल्ड इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. क्लियर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस स्टेट इज नोन एज इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एज ए प्लस बी रिवर्सिबल सी प्लस डी. दिस वन इज आर एफ एंड दिस इज आर बी. देयरफोर एट इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट आर एफ मस्ट बी इक्वल टू आर बी. सच स्टेट इज नोन एज इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. एंड वन थिंग इज दैट इज वेरी कॉमन अबाउट द इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट. एंड व्हाट इज दैट थिंग? यू नो बेसिकली एट इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट why rf becomes equal to rb because of the concentration of reactant is equal to the concentration of product. When the concentration of reactant must be equal to the concentration product, no doubt in this state rate of forward reaction must becomes equal to the rate of backward reaction. Means Rm must be equal to R. Clear? And equilibrium state of any chemical reaction is a dynamic state. Do you know what is the reason why equilibrium state of any reversible reaction is also considered as dynamic state? Because equilibrium word is associated with reaction if reaction used to stand always in running state. रिएक्शन जब रनिंग स्टेट में रहेगी तभी तो उसमें इक्वलिब्रियम रहेगा. आर एम इक्वल टू आर एम यूज टू इंडिकेट दैट रिएक्टेंट यूज टू कन्वर्ट इन टू प्रोडक्ट एंड आर बी यूज टू इंडिकेट दैट प्रोडक्ट अगेन कन्वर्ट इन टू रिएक्टेंट. हेंस रिएक्शन रन कंटिन्यूअसली. अल्टीमेटली वी कैन डिक्लेयर दैट द इक्वलिब्रियम स्टेट ऑफ एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन इज अ डायनामिक स्टेट. क्लियर? नाउ आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग व्हाट इज द इक्वलिब्रियम स्टेट. Clear? Now one thing I want to discuss about equilibrium constant. After discussing about the equilibrium state, now I want to discuss about equilibrium constant. Let us discuss about equilibrium constant. What is the equilibrium constant? Yes, consider about given reaction. Let's consider given reaction A plus B reversible C plus D RF RB. Okay? Then according to law mass action, or we can say according to rate law, what? Rf directly proportional to concentration of A into concentration of B. Why? Because for the rate of forward reaction, A and B are considered as a reactant. And rate of reaction depend on the concentration of reactant, which is implies Rf is equal to K1 concentration of A into concentration of B. Equation first. And what is K1 here? K1 is forward rate constant. K1 here is forward rate constant. By the same way, Rb is equal to, we can write directly, Rb is equal to K2 concentration of C into concentration of D. Rb must be equal to K2 concentration of C into concentration of D. Equation second. And where is K2? What is K2 here? K2 backward rate constant. Okay? Here K2 is considered to be the backward rate constant. But you know, at equilibrium state, Rf must be equal to Rb. This is the concept. Basically, at equilibrium state, rate of forward reaction must be equal to rate of backward reaction. Now, you can substitute the value of Rf from equation first and substitute the value of Rb from equation second. In place of Rf, we can write here K1 concentration of A into concentration of B. In place of Rb, K2 concentration of C into concentration of D. Okay? Now, concentration, concentration one side and constant, constant one side. K1 upon K2 is equal to concentration of C, concentration of D, whole upon concentration of A, concentration of B. This, in place of K1 and K2, we can write here Kc, concentration of C, concentration of D, a whole upon concentration of A into concentration of B. Here Kc is considered to be the equilibrium constant. Here Kc is considered to be the equilibrium constant. Therefore, K1 upon K2 must be equal to Kc. Until this is the way. This is the way to find out the expression for equilibrium constant. And what is the Kc? Kc is considered to be equilibrium constant. Hence we can declare that the ratio of forward velocity constant and backward velocity constant is equal to equilibrium constant. किसी रिएक्शन का फॉरवर्ड वेलोसिटी कांस्टेंट और बैकवर्ड वेलोसिटी कांस्टेंट, इन दोनों के रेशियो को ही क्या बोलते हैं? दैट इज सिंपली नोन एज इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट. एंड दिस इज द वे टू डिराइव द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन इन टर्म्स ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम कांस्टेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग वन एग्जाम्पल. स्पेशली वन एग्जाम्पल as for the given reaction. Reaction is N2 plus thrice H2, reversible, twice NH3. N2 plus thrice H2, reversible, 2 NH3. Here RF and next one is the RB. RF as well as RB. And all these are present in gaseous state. I will discuss later about this. Then its equilibrium constant, Kc is equal to, this one is the product. Because here, first of all, in above we have to write the concentration of product and below concentration of reactant. By the same way here, hum likhenge concentration of NH3 ka power 2 ka whole upon concentration of N2 whole upon concentration of N2 into concentration of H2 ke power 3. Because you know, coefficient are written in terms of power. Hence we can decide that the expression for the equilibrium constant for any chemical reactions. Ultimately, in this lecture, I have discussed. मैंने क्या क्या discuss किया? Rate of reaction, rate law, concentration, rate constant, equilibrium state, as well as equilibrium constant. Okay? आज इस lecture में यही था. Next part अगले lecture में discuss करेंगे. Thank you. Good.